and happy Thursday. It's me, your songwriting partner, your co-producer, and as always, your friend, Joe Seabee. And happy Wednesday, guys. And Wednesday is part of our creative writing series. Actually, we have two nights that we do this. Tonight, which is Wednesday, and Thursday, we have a class, a follow-up class that is called Picture This. It's when I show you an image, and then you have to write a chorus on that image. But this is our first part of our series. This is the ghostwriting class. It's when we take a popular song that's on the Billboard charts right now, and we take the chorus only, we rewrite all the words with our own original words, and replace the original words with our own. So that's what this class is about. Why do we do this? Well, it's a very super creative exercise. It forces you to come up with a story in only a certain amount of lines, because you know the song only has so many lines. So you have to tell your side of whatever story you're telling in that short amount of time. So you can't meander too much. Of course, there are rules to this. One of the rules is you can't use any of their words. Your song's got to tell a story. It's got to rhyme, and it's got to make sense. Because you know, songs make sense. You know, that there's a storyline, there's a theme, you know, and so you have to come up with that. And the other reason we do this too is because it really helps advance your lyric vocabulary. You know, because you know, I mean, whatever the subject matter of the song is, you can borrow from that. If you wanted your song to be similar to the theme of the song, you can do that just as long as you don't use any of the words, you know. So, I mean, it could be about whatever you want it to be, but like, because there's already sort of like a theme there, you could create one based around the theme that's already there. There's no rules in that. The only rules, like I said, only rules in place are it's gotta rhyme, gotta tell a story, gotta make sense. That's it. Everything else is up to you. And of course, it's whatever you write has got to fit the melody perfectly. You can't have more syllables than what's there, you know? So that's something to think about as well. Okay, so, you know, I was listening to different songs and I thought, what's got enough words, but not too many where this would cause you to be like working for hours and hours and hours? Because some, you know, I have used songs that were like really long. The choruses are really long. And that's a lot of words. And it's a lot of thinking. And I get that. You know, it's, it can be tough. But, you know, it's, these are, you know, these two exercises a week that I give you that are really difficult. I give them to you because I want you to challenge yourself. That's one. I really want you to push yourself to your limit and really go the extra mile. And these are these exercises where I tell you every week, go in a room by yourself, shut the door, don't multitask. You shouldn't be texting your friends or Facebook messengering people while you're doing this. I want you to watch these videos I give you, because I always find the lyric videos, post them. Then you should write down all the words, and you know, hit your pause button when the lyrics come up for the chorus. Pause it, write it down, unpause it, pause it when the next line comes up, write that down, but leave a space so you can write your line directly underneath of it, you know? I'm going to show you all that in a minute, you know, how to really write your parts down so that, you know. And you guys see this. I mean, most of you come every week and see how I do this. But, you know, this is one of those things where I really think it's important that I stress this over and over and over again. I'm going to show you, well, I'm going to tell you what song it is in a minute. But before that, these are great exercises just to get your mind working. Expand your mind. Get your lyric vocabulary up. What do I mean by that? Well, like, you know, like I said, you only have so many lines to finish your statement. So you can't make up, your story's got to be direct, straight, and to the point, you know? So I'm going to tell you the song that we're doing tonight, which is, it's Justin Bieber's song, Peaches, okay? So it's the song Peaches, but with your original lyrics, okay? So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to play you that chorus, okay? So I'm going to play you the chorus from Justin Bieber's track. And then you can watch the lyrics and respond. And then I'll show you how I go about creating my words directly under his. Okay, so without further ado, here is Justin Bieber's Peaches, the chorus. Here it is.
I got my peaches out in Georgia. Oh yeah, shit. I get my weed from California. That's that shit. I took my chick up to the north, yeah. Badass bitch. I get my light right from the source, yeah. Yeah, that's it. I got my peaches out in Georgia. Oh yeah, shit. I get my weed from California. That's that shit. I took my chick up to the north, yeah. Badass bitch. I get my light right from the source, yeah. Yeah, that's it.
All right, so you heard the chorus. You saw the words. That's it, right? He repeats the whole thing two times. You just have to write one whole hook and then repeat it, okay? So I'm going to read you his words almost like they're a poem. I'm not going to sing them. I'm just going to speak them, okay? I got my peaches out in Georgia. Oh, yeah, shit. I get my weed from California. That's that shit. I took my chick up to the north. Yeah, badass bitch. I get my light right from the source. Yeah, yeah, that's it. So that's his words. So I'm going to show you. This is his words. I get my peaches out in Georgia. Oh, that shit. See, I put those in parentheses there. But you notice how I put every word, and then there's a little line, a dot, and then between each one, even when it's a two-syllable word, like peaches, I get my, okay, so it's I, one syllable, get, my is all one syllable. The first two-syllable word is peaches, peaches, I get my peaches, so if you add that whole thing up. I get, so it's I dot get dot my dot peach dot is dot out dot in dot George dot Georgia. Okay. And then you see under that is I write mine. You know that, you know, so here's mine, right? You know that, baby, I adore ya. So, I get my peaches out in Georgia. You know that, baby, I adore ya. That's what I wrote. So, like, every single line, see? You dot know dot that dot. You know that, baby, dot I dot dot door dot ya. And then I write, swear to you, instead of, oh, that's it, okay? Swear to you, right? You know that, baby, I adore you, swear I do, I swear to you. Okay, so you see how, like, I try to match when he has a two-syllable word, I try to do a two-syllable word. But you don't necessarily have to do a two-syllable word. If you can only think of, like, one syllable word, but you can, like, you can use, okay, like, say, peaches is two syllable word, right? You can write love you. If you could write love you, you could write, you know, we know. I mean, whatever your line is, you can use two single syllable words together right underneath the two syllable word. It still counts. It's fine. So that way you know that you're able to do that. You see how, and every one, it says, his, mine. So that's Justin Bieber's line, my line. Justin's line, my line. Justin's, mine. Justin's, mine. All the way down. You see that? So, that's how I want you to do yours, okay? I want you to write your line, Then directly underneath, I want you to write your line. Every word under the word. Every word under Justin's word. Like, you know, Justin's words here, your word should go right under. Same way. Line it up perfectly so there's no, you don't have like more words than Justin has, okay? Even if you got to put 2 one-syllable words under a 2-syllable word, that's fine. Okay, so just so you know that. So anyway, I found a karaoke version of this song, so I'm going to play it for you right now. So here it is. Here we go. You know that, baby, I adore you, swear to you. I'll never put no one before you, know it's true. When I met you, I made a promise for all you do. You are the love, you are my goddess. Guys, I can't wait to see what you guys wrote for that chorus. Until tomorrow, this is your songwriting partner, your co-producer, and your friend, Joe CB, signing off. Have a great night, guys. I love you. Be safe, and I will see you all tomorrow. Peace.